There's a very beautiful Sufi story. A Sufi mystic was there, I forget his name. A great Sufi mystic there he was. The king invited him to the palace. He was invited to the palace to come for a dinner, right? He was a very great Urdu poet. So therefore he was invited. When invited, the gateman did not allow him. You know why the gateman did not allow him? Because he was wearing a very shabby dress. And the king's palace, you know, he was not invited. Since he was not invited, he said, no, he thought he's some type of beggar, you know, go, it is only for the royal people. He said, the king has invited me. He said, no, go. So this man went away. He was a mystic, he was a poet, he was a Urdu poet. So he went away. Having gone away, he wears a nice dress and comes. Then the gateman allows him, come inside. Aye, andar. He sits down. When he sits down, the king bowed down to him. He sat down, take his coat and kept it there. And when food was served, he was giving the coat. Coffee and whatever it is, it was given to the coat. And he was such a great poet, he was. The king got confused. He said, why are you feeding the coat? I said, in your kingdom, people only understand people only in the outer layer, not in the inner layer. Because then he explained, when I didn't come in this, he did not come inside. Right? Please understand, therefore I'm saying, if I'm used to this type of dress, I may say to remind myself what this is, but now if this becomes my identity becomes my imprisonment. It doesn't become my real quintessence. So ask yourself, everybody defines an identity. We create our own niche. And then afterwards, that niche that we create becomes our imprisonment, becomes our entrapment. And in this entrapment, yatatam api siddhanam kaschit mam veti tattvataha. So manushyanam sahasreshu, among thousands of people, very few people seek me, that we have seen. Among those people who are putting effort also, yatatam api siddhanam, among those people who are putting effort, putting prayatnam, they also, very few people reach me. Yatatam api siddhanam kaschin mam veti tattvataha. Very few people know me. Why very few people know me? Because, please understand, you go to an ashram, you go to a guru, you learn. Afterwards, you create an identity. Afterwards, that identity becomes your entrapment. Therefore, Adi Shankaracharya says, a true wise person, yogratha, let it be even bogratova, sangratova sangavihinaha, yasya chittam brahmari namate, nandati 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 eva. A wise man can be in yoga, he can also be in boga. Sangratova, he can be in sangaha, in the midst of people. Sangavihinaha, he can be a recluse. Hey, but he is always nandati 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 eva. That means his identity is not entrapped, whether he is in yoga or whether he is in boga. Oh, if he is a yogi, he should be. Look at Lord Krishna's life. There was no mass you can trap him, isn't it? He helped Arjuna in eloping with his own sister also. I'm not requesting you to do all that, okay? Don't hear me wrongly, because people listen what they want to listen. I'm talking, his consciousness is so free. When Arjuna was in love with his sister, he helped him. He was a warrior, and even as a warrior, you see, he took a condition. He is so free. He took a condition, I am not going to fight. Whether he want my army or want me. A wise person cannot be predicted to any behavior. Please listen carefully. A wise person cannot be predicted to any behavior. He is an unpredictable person. Because his life is a flow of intelligence. It is not a flow of static conclusions. We understand a person with static conclusions. Somebody went to Lord Buddha, bowed down to him and asked him, is there God? Buddha said no. That person thanked him and went away. Somebody asked next day, or somebody, and the same day somebody asked, is there God? Buddha said yes. He bowed and went away. Third person, somebody came, is there God? Buddha remained quiet. He said, thank you very much, and he went away. Ananda, his closest disciple, was utterly confused, you know. Hare, same day, same question, is there God? Three different answers. And Ananda, closest disciple of Buddha and the cousin of Lord Buddha, bows down to him and said, "Oh, Master, I can't understand. Is there a God? First you said yes to him, second you said no to him, and third person you remained quiet." To which, you know, what Buddha said so beautifully, "I love this, and based on this is my life workshop, my YLP programs that I do." And you know what he said? He said, when the first man said, "Is there a God?" I saw in his eyes there was so much of disbelief in God. He was an atheist. And Buddha never spoke of God. He spoke of truth. Like Jai Krishnamurti, he spoke of truth. So I saw so much of belief of God does not exist, disbelief. I said yes to him to break his belief system. To a person who was a believer of God, I saw his belief did not help him to flower forth as a wise person. His belief was an entrapment. And to him I said, "Is there God?" I said, "Yes." "No." Because he was a believer in God, so I said, "No." To a disbeliever, he said, "Yes." To a third person who was neither a believer, neither a disbeliever, right? Buddha said, he was neither a believer, neither a disbeliever. I remained silent. Means in silence, you discover God. Because only in silence can you discover God. Right? Now you see the style which Buddha answered. You can't predict him. A master cannot be predicted. Not that he is chanchalam. Because he doesn't answer a question. He answers a questioner who is asking the question. He doesn't answer the question, he answers the questioner. He is not bothered whether you are going to appreciate him or depreciate him. He is more interested in awakening you, not putting you into sleep, awakening you. And therefore, please understand, our identity becomes our entrapment. So you go to an ashram, you create an identity. Afterwards, what happened? You don't think, the identity thinks. You don't think, the identity thinks. When the identity thinks and you don't think, then identity is not going to be enlightened. You have to be enlightened. And therefore, we build our own graveyard in which we get buried. Therefore, yatatam api siddhanam kaschin mam veti tatvataha. Even if you put effort, it is this sleeping person who is putting effort. It is this identity which is putting effort. And therefore the Lord says, very few people know me. Because the very effort is coming from a sleeping consciousness, is not coming from an awake consciousness. Therefore, manushyanam sahasreshu kaschit yatati siddhaye yatatam api siddhanam kaschit mam veti tatvataha. Very few people really recognize me, Arjuna, because they are all putting effort. Please relax. Even if you do, all of you are understanding, I know. Even if you don't understand, relax. Who gets restless? The identity. Oh, you, I'm not understanding. That identity is the problem, actually. It is this ego which is, you know, a lot of, some people get tensed up even in enlightenment. Swamiji, when will I get enlightened? Enlightenment is the tension disappears. Unless you lose that identity, it is not possible. A person, you know, was a young boy, was climbing a wall, and he was plucking a certain type of fruits, which, you know, in a lengthy form, you know, it is in the form, fruit. He was in a wall, the risky is put, he was plucking the type of fruits there. And as he was plucking there, he was about to hold a scorpion, because the scorpion also looked like a certain type of fruit. And the scorpion told him, it seems, if you hold me, you will lose me and lose your life also. And all the fruits that you have. If you hold me, you will lose me, lose you, and all the fruits that you are holding. You know, he holds the scorpion is going to bite, then you are going to lose. You are going to lose yourself because you are going to fall from the wall. And you lose all the fruits which you have already collected, if you hold me. If you hold your ego, you will lose yourself, and all the fruits that you have collected also you will lose. So better drop that ego. Better drop that ego. Please understand, it may take time, but drop the ego. How to drop the ego? Lord Krishna says that beautifully. And how do you drop the ego? Tadviddhi pranipadena pariprashnena sevaya upadekshanti te jnanam jnaninaha tattvadarshinaha. He says, understand, do seva to the master. There's a beautiful, beautiful subhashitam, right? Yata kanan kanitrena, please listen to this, a beautiful subhashitam which says, yata kanan kanitrena naro vayuradikachati evam gurugatam vidyam guru shishuro shishurushaha adikachati. Means, what does it mean? Yata kanan, how a digger digs and gets water. How you have to dig to get water. And next sloka I'll talk about water. You have to dig and get water. So to also, evam guru gatam vidyam, to your guru, you have to dig him. Not dig him, is poke him. Right? Do shushrusha adhikachati, by constantly serving and respecting him. Like how you dig and get water, so too also you can get this. Bhuprakha. Just feel this sloka. Just close your eyes, all of you close your eyes.
Yatha khanan khanitrena naro vāryadigacchati evam guru gatam vidyam shushrushradigacchati shushrushradigacchati.
Close your eyes and full of devotion, learn to seek the blessing of the Lord. Give me this vidya of the Lord where I can serve the Master, serve Lord Krishna and gain this sukshma vidya from the Lord. Hara hara. A lot of devotion. Keep your eyes closed. A lot of devotion. Seek the Lord.
Shankara Samba Sada Shiva Isha Mahesha.
Hara Hara Shankara Samba Sada Shiva Isha Mahesha.
Hara Hara Shankara Samba Sada Shiva Isha Mahesha. Chandra Kaladhar Isha Mahesha.
Pandava Priyakar Chandra Kaladhar Isha Mahesha.
Pandava Priyakar. प्रिय कलचंद्र कला।